station started as a small news portal. Now this is the first event from House of Station. As we all know, the Lok Sabha elections are at the doorstep. So we are having a small political talk show and a small political debate on this Lok Sabha elections. So there are two sides. There are two sides of the coin. On one side of the coin is the government has to continue. The current present BJP NDA government has to continue for the next 5 years. And the other side, the flip side is the government has to change. The new government has to come in. So we have two sides. Those who want the government to continue can sit on this side, and the people who want a change in the government can sit on this side. So I please welcome the people who want to participate in this debate. Please. As we know, one of the famous leaders in India has a little aversion for press conferences. As we know, he don't like debates, public debates. So, unfortunately, his followers don't like the same. So, I'm sorry for you guys, actually, this side is vacant. Anyway, we have to continue the debate. So, we will start the debate and we'll change little because there is a, it will be one side. So, we'll change into a little discussion.
ഇവിടെ കൂടി ഒരു പലരും മലയാളികളായതുകൊണ്ടും നമുക്ക് കുറച്ചുകൂടെ കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ എളുപ്പമുള്ള ഒരു ലാംഗ്വേജ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷും മലയാളം ആയതുകൊണ്ടും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇഷ്ടമുള്ള ലാംഗ്വേജിൽ ഈ ഡിബേറ്റ് മുമ്പോട്ട് പോകാനുള്ള അനുവാദം കൂടി ഉണ്ടാകും. അപ്പോൾ മാധ്യമങ്ങളെ എന്നും ഭയപ്പെടുന്ന ഒരു അവസ്ഥ ഇന്ത്യയിൽ ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുണ്ട് ഈ കഴിഞ്ഞ 5 വർഷം. അതിൻ്റെ ഒരു തുടർ ചലനം എന്ന പോലെ തന്നെയാണ് ഈ ഡിബേറ്റിൽ നമുക്ക് പ്രതിനിധിക്കാൻ സാധിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഒഴിഞ്ഞു കിടക്കുന്ന ഈ ഇരിപ്പിടങ്ങളാണ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് മുമ്പിൽ ഞങ്ങൾ നൽകുന്ന തെളിവുകൾ. കാരണം ഈ ഗവൺമെൻറ് തുടരണോ വേണ്ടയോ എന്ന ശക്തമായ ചോദ്യത്തിന് ഇവർ നൽകുന്ന മറുപടിയായിരിക്കും CUTന്റെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വിദ്യാർത്ഥികളുടെ ഇടയിൽ നിന്ന് നമുക്ക് ലഭിക്കുന്ന ഏറ്റവും വലിയൊരു ആയുധമായി ഇവിടുന്ന് കണക്കാക്കാൻ സാധിക്കുന്നത്. ഗവൺമെൻറ് തുടരണമെന്ന് ഈ കൂട്ടത്തിൽ ആർക്കെങ്കിലും തോന്നുന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അവർക്ക് പാർട്ടിയുടെ ഇല്ല, രാഷ്ട്രീയത്തിൻ്റെ ഇല്ല, മതത്തിൻ്റെ ഇല്ല, യാതൊരു ബൗണ്ടറിയും ഇല്ലാതെ ഈ സീറ്റുകളിൽ വന്നിരിക്കാവുന്നതാണ്. ഇത് അവസാന ചാൻസാണ്.
These are not for the government, it's not for the NDA, actually these two guys are from the Kashmir. So we can hear a little different story, different perspective from these guys. So that's why they are sitting on this side. Okay, we'll start the debate or we'll start the discussion.
You said India is booming as an economic power, but in an election, it's just not economy. Like 40 or 30 years ago, the slogan that was raised by Indira Gandhi was Roti Kapda Aur Makan. I don't know whether it's Indira Gandhi, if I'm wrong, just correct me. But now it is like Roti Kapda Makan plus internet. But that is not the case anymore. In 2019, what we Indians need the most is nothing but freedom. That's why the chant of Azadi is echoing everywhere in India. So keeping aside economy, we need more freedom that in the economic sphere and also in a personal and social life. Coming to the economics point that you raised, who is having this development? India's GDP is going up. But when you ask me, as a person, I have a dual identity of a student as well as a youth. As a student, now I want to pursue my PhD. But the government is now issuing orders like no PhDs without interest of national priorities won't be entertained. So who is setting national priorities is a question. So any work that doesn't entertain the government or that doesn't glorify the government would not be entertained. That is the message it is giving. Now coming back to the other identity of a youth, there are not enough jobs for us. If unemployment is the highest in the last 41 or 42 years. So my problem, as you mentioned in the economic or sphere, is as a youth is about jobs, lack of jobs. If I'm stopping here, my studies, if I'm not pursuing PhD, I want to work so that I can stay, and there are people who are dependent on me, my family. So there comes the problem of jobs. And if you are discussing economics, my question is about jobs. And that itself is my dissent against this government, lack of creating enough jobs.
So that is about the economy. Now we will talk about little bit about what is happening around the intellectual sphere of this country. Actually, more than 100 prominent writers, more than 100 prominent directors started a campaigning against NDA. They told like they are not interested in the continuation of the government. There are a lot of problems going on. So we'll ask about that.
More than this, 100 directors or intellectuals or literary activities. Their path is right or their stand is actually right. From the start of this NDA government, if you will revert to the section of literature, film, and any other else like cultural activities, we can see what a fear in that area. Firstly, I will mention with the Pune Film Institute issue. The appointment of director of Film Institute, chairman or director, I think the salutation is director, the Gajendra Chauhan was appointed as Film Institute chairman, which we had seen a wide rebellion against that issues by students. And then we come to the issue of Gauri Lankesh, the murder of Gauri Lankesh, Govind Pansare, Dabolkar, then Gulbargi. So these murders, which shows that it's they are suppressing the dissent against them through pen works or literary works and all the things. So this NDA government need to shut up the mouths of dissent.
നമുക്കറിയാം, ഭാരതം എന്ന രാജ്യത്തിൻ്റെ ജനാധിപത്യ വിശ്വാസത്തിൻ്റെ നാലാമത്തെ നെടുന്തൂണെന്നറിയപ്പെടുന്നത് മാധ്യമങ്ങളാണ്. ആ മാധ്യമ പ്രവർത്തനത്തിന് വ്യക്തമായിട്ടുള്ള സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ ഒരു അഞ്ച് വർഷമായിട്ട് കുറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു കാര്യം നമുക്ക് കാണാൻ സാധിക്കും. അപ്പോൾ ഒരു മീഡിയ സ്റ്റുഡൻ്റ് എന്ന നിലയിൽ, ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട പോളിനോടാണ് എൻ്റെ അടുത്ത ചോദ്യം, ഒരു മീഡിയ സ്റ്റുഡൻ്റ് എന്ന നിലയിൽ അടുത്ത അഞ്ച് വർഷത്തേക്ക് മാധ്യമ പ്രവർത്തനത്ത് സുസ്ഥിരതയോടെ പ്രവർത്തിക്കണമെങ്കിൽ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇന്ത്യയുടെ മാധ്യമങ്ങൾക്ക് കൂച്ചുവിലങ്ങില്ലെങ്കിൽ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മാധ്യമങ്ങളെ നേരിടുവാൻ വേണ്ടി ഭയപ്പാടില്ലാത്ത ഒരു ഭരണകൂടമുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അതിനുവേണ്ടിയല്ലേ നിങ്ങൾ വോട്ട് ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്? അതിനുള്ള മറുപടി താങ്കളുടെ ഭാഗത്തു നിന്ന് എന്താണെന്നാണ് പോളിനോടുള്ള എൻ്റെ ചോദ്യം.
ഈ മാധ്യമങ്ങൾ എങ്ങനെ ഈ ഗവൺമെൻറ്റിനെ നേരിട്ടു എന്നുള്ളത് ശരിക്കും ചോദ്യം ചെയ്യപ്പെടേണ്ടതാണ്. പലതരത്തിലും ഈ മാധ്യമങ്ങൾ അതിൽ പരാജയപ്പെട്ടു എന്ന് വേണം പറയാം. ഇപ്പോൾ ഉദാഹരണത്തിന് അതിന് പല കാരണങ്ങളുണ്ട്. ഇപ്പോൾ ഉദാഹരണത്തിന് ക്വിൻ്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു ഓൺലൈൻ അതായത് ബി ജെ പിക്കെതിരെ വളരെ നിരന്തരം പോസ്റ്റുകൾ ഇട്ടുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ക്വിൻ്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന സ്ഥാപനത്തിന് നേരെ റെയ്ഡ് വരുന്നു. മണിപ്പൂരിലെ ഒരു മാധ്യമ അവിടുത്തെ ചീഫ് മിനിസ്റ്റർക്കും ബി ജെ പി നരേന്ദ്ര മോദിയൊക്കെ എതിരെ എഴുതുന്ന സംസാരിച്ച ഒരു മാധ്യമപ്രവർത്തനെ അറസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നു. അയാൾ ഇതുവരെ പുറത്തായിട്ടില്ല. അപ്പോൾ ഇങ്ങനെ പല കാര്യങ്ങളിലൂടെ മാധ്യമപ്രവർത്തകരുടെ സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം ഹനിക്കപ്പെടുകയാണ്. ഇത് മാത്രമല്ല, മാധ്യമപ്രവർത്തകർ ഈ സമയത്ത് എന്ത് ചെയ്യുന്നു എന്നുള്ള കാര്യം വളരെ ചോദ്യപ്പെടുകയാണ്. ഇപ്പോൾ കേരളത്തിൽ മീശ എന്ന് പറയുന്നൊരു നോവൽ റിലീസ് മാതൃഭൂമി എന്ന് പറയുന്നൊരു ആശുപത്രിയിൽ വരികയും തുടർന്ന് ഇവിടുത്തെ സംഘപരിവാർ അതിനെ വളരെയധികം എതിർക്കുകയൊക്കെ ചെയ്തൊരു അനുഭവം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അപ്പോൾ ഇതിനെപ്പറ്റി മാതൃഭൂമിയിൽ നിന്ന് കമൽറാം സജീവ് ഇതിനെപ്പറ്റി ഒരു ചർച്ചയിൽ പറഞ്ഞൊരു കാര്യം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അതായത് ഈ ഒരു കേസ് ഈ മീശ നിരോധിച്ചു അതിനെതിരെ ആദ്യം കേസ് കൊടുത്തത് മാതൃഭൂമിയായിരുന്നു. പക്ഷേ ഈ കേസിൻ്റെ വിജയം അത് മാതൃഭൂമി പത്രത്തിൽ ഒരു ചെറിയൊരു കോളത്തിലാണ് വന്നത്. മാതൃഭൂമിക്കകത്ത് അത് സെലിബ്രേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ പോലുള്ള ഒരു ഇത് മാതൃഭൂമിക്ക് ഉണ്ടായില്ല. നടന്നു വെച്ചാൽ എന്താണ്, മാതൃഭൂമിയെ സപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്ന മാതൃഭൂമിയിൽ പരസ്യം കൊടുക്കുന്ന നിരവധി അനവധി കമ്പനീസിനോട് ബി ജെ പി അനുകൂലമായിട്ടുള്ള ആ കമ്പനീസ് പറഞ്ഞു ഈ വാർത്ത അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഈ വിഷയം നിങ്ങൾ മുന്നോട്ട് കൊണ്ടുപോകുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങളുടെ ഫണ്ടിങ് നിങ്ങളുടെ അഡ്വർട്ടൈസ്മെൻറ്സ് ഞങ്ങൾ കട്ട് ചെയ്യും. അങ്ങനെ ഒരു തരത്തിൽ മാധ്യമങ്ങളെ വളരെയധികം എന്താ പറയുക സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം ഹനിക്കപ്പെടുന്ന മാധ്യമങ്ങളെ വാ മൂടി കിട്ടുന്ന ഒരു തരത്തിലുള്ള ഒരു പ്രവർത്തനമായിരുന്നു നടന്നുകൊണ്ടിരുന്നത്. പക്ഷേ ഇതിൽ വളരെ ഇത് എന്താ പറയുക, അപ്പോൾ തീർച്ചയായും ഇങ്ങനൊരു ഗവൺമെൻറ് ഇവിടെ തുടരേണ്ടതല്ല. മാധ്യമങ്ങൾക്ക് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം കൊടുക്കുന്ന ഒരു ഗവൺമെൻറ്, ജനങ്ങളുടെ ഡിസെൻറ്റിന് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം കൊടുക്കുന്ന അവസരം കൊടുക്കുന്ന ഒരു ഗവൺമെൻറ് ആണ് ഇവിടെ വരേണ്ടത്.
ദ കോൺഗ്രസ് മാനിഫെസ്റ്റോ ഇസ് ഔട്ട് ആൻഡ് വൺ ഓഫ് ദ ഗുഡ് തിങ്സ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് മാനിഫെസ്റ്റോ ഇസ് ദ സെഡീഷൻ ആക്ട്. സെഡീഷൻ ആക്ട് ഇസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു ബി റൂൾഡ് ഔട്ട്. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ വൺ പോസിറ്റീവ് തിങ് ദാറ്റ് വി ഹാവ് ഹേർഡ്. സോ ദ സെഡീഷൻ ആക്ട് ഇസ് ദ ടൂൾ ദാറ്റ് ഹാവ് ബീൻ യൂസ്ഡ് ടു കണ്ടെയ്ൻ ദ മീഡിയ houses in India as well as the journalists in India. So that is going to be ruled out. That's a positive thing. And one more thing for us, actually, a guy, a friend of us, came here as a pro-government. So I'm very much happy to welcome him to this side. Please welcome. Please take a seat. So actually we are eagerly waiting to hear what you have to say.
Okay, well, I know many of all of you have got good points and many points in fact. Why not to support this government? But my question is, why to support Rahul Gandhi? Can anyone tell me any good qualities of Rahul Gandhi? Any good qualities? If a party don't have a good face, not a good character, I don't find anything good in him, then why to vote for him? Why? Question is why? The big question mark, why? Where, if you see, there are two faces only. I'm not particularly supporting Narendra Modi. I'm not particularly supporting this BJP government. But do I have any other option? Either to be in big chaos, or either to go for a good track. If I see a road here and other side a big jungle, definitely I will choose a road only, no? I know that this road can lead me to somewhere. But if I see the jungle, I know that I need to cut it out. I need to make a road. I need to make a good road. Then I can move on. Congress projected in 2012 elections that they are going to increase the education budget by 3% to 6%. But in their own government, they did it only 2.7%. Why did not increase? They promised to increase women's safety. They promised. But was it fulfilled? No. The major point I would like to discuss here, that at least India is reacting at this stage. Reacting. There was surgical strike. I'm not supporting government, that government is taking credit. But we are responding. As a civil government, India is responding. And what was happened in 2008 with the Mumbai attack? We were sitting quietly. We were sitting quiet. We did not respond it. But we are responding this time. And things are changing, maybe slowly, but things are changing. It's not that things are completely stopped. We are not getting into chaos that there is a major Gathbandhan. Whosoever be chief minister, whosoever be the prime minister, there is no specific face. I know there are young leaders like Kanhaiya Kumar and Tejaswi Surya, let me correct myself. But they are young and they are supporting their own ideologies. They are actually. But in spite of getting into ditch, I better see a road to go upon, to go. Thank you.
Good points actually he made. Like Rahul Gandhi was not as strong as Narendra Modi, who reacted suddenly when the armed forces was killed in Pulwama, who readily attacked. And Manmohan Singh was quietly sitting when the Mumbai attacks was happened. Little question for you, but I'm unfortunately the mediator, so I can't. So anyone want to react for that?
Ran said that he saw a very good road. I said I will support you. Okay. In 2014, Indian citizens were given a future promise that there will be a very good road. People believed that. And people started to walk on through that road. Finally, they had reached to a great jungle. So in 2019, the Indian citizen has a clear idea to do what? Definitely, I will say Rahul Gandhi is the present best leader against Narendra Modi. Rahul Gandhi is the best alternative towards Narendra Modi. See why? He has the ability to hear what people say. He is having a kind mentality to be with the people. See what happened with Narendra Modi. See, I will give you a simple example. Rahul Gandhi came to Chennai and he had interacted with the students in Stella Maris College. The way he believes itself gives the citizens of India a thought that he is the future prime minister. In 2014, BJP had said what Congress had done for 60 years. Now Narendra Modi has said in last day in North that UPA had took, now Congress had took 60 years to do something. How can I do within 5 years? He said within 5 years we will change India, into a modern India. What he had done?
Why Rahul Gandhi? Why he is 1,000 times better than present Prime Minister? The family which is continuously ruling the India, what changes this family has made to India? What changes? After the 1992, when the India was open for world economics, when the world can enter India and do their industry setup, go for marketing, after that India started developing. After that 1992, because India got a big crisis at that time. India don't have money in their reserve banks. India don't have money to feed their own people. And this was in Congress time. Why? Why there was emergency? Why? Was this not a failure of Congress? Second question. I would like to answer second part of it. Rahul Gandhi, so-called Pappu. Pappu, who is giving messages like, I'll give a machine to change a potato into gold.
Did he ever say that?
तू मुझे मैं ऐसी मशीन बनाऊंगा यहाँ पे आलू डालूंगा यहाँ सोना निकलेगा. What was this?
कभी उसने ऐसा बोला था?
Yes.
आपको प्रूफ है उसने ऐसा?
We have seen the videos. We have seen the videos.
No, let him. Let him.
I'll tell. Don't worry. So these were completely fake promises. I know he's working on gaining the farmer support, gaining. In his latest manifesto, he's trying to implement to remove ASFA. I know he's trying to work upon, but he has been failed a lot. A person who has already failed, you are trying to believe him that now this time he'll successful. See the background of the people. Background of your leader, the one who comes from the royal family, you are just supporting them because this is not a person to support. In this present scenario, I don't want to get into Narendra Modi family background, but till now, Narendra Modi families are still living their own general life only. They don't have any good homes, good luxuries life. No. They are living as normal. And on the other hand, you are just targeting him that not to vote him. With no any clear points. Just trying to remove him. Because a person who struggles, a person who sees a vision, there will be people always against him. And that I believe. Thank you.
Three friends from the topmost, the North Indian most state of India, the Jammu and Kashmir. So we can hear what they have to say about the Indian politics, Indian election coming in the 2019 election. So let me pass the mic to...
Good evening, everyone. My name is Asif. I'm from Kashmir. 2 days back, if you talk about BJP and Congress, for me personally, they are the none of the above people. So I don't support them both. So a few days back, somebody told me that, are you going to vote on 11th April? And I said, yeah, I can vote, but I have to spend around 10,000 rupees for flight from here to Kashmir, then from 10,000 from back. And after reaching there, I have to put the none of the above button. So what is the reason to spend this much money? So that was the first question. And when you talk about that, Albert was saying that we were having that issue, roti, kapda and makan. But I will tell you one thing. In Kashmir, it was never an issue, roti, kapda and makan. It was for Kashmiris, elections were only won on the basis of people's sentiments and people's emotions. The first thing, If you see the change, I will tell you some facts about the change. Atul was saying what happened in this, what happened in... Up to 2018, even being a conflicting state, most conflicting area, where government of India doesn't matter which government is going to be the form the government in J&K, they only need the number of votes there, because they want to show that people of Kashmir, they believe in the constitution of India. And it was really happening up to 2018, that up to 2000, even being a conflicting state also, there was 70%, 80% voting in Jammu and Kashmir, which was more than any state. Then same thing changed to 2014 elections, which goes straightly from 70% to the 7% voting. And that was a disastrous change. And the major cause of this change was the attitude of the government, attitude of this system towards the people, where the people who are even serving the government of India, who are the employee of India, they are going and they are fighting against voting, and they are supporting the boycott campaigns, and they are supporting to even breaking these ballot machines. And this was the situation in Kashmir I have seen. When you say about roti kapda and makan, we don't need roti kapda and makan. We can arrange that thing. Every time, whenever I vote, last time I voted, it was my first voting during this 2014 election, I think. And it was my first vote. And I never see who is saying that we'll give school, we'll give education. We always have only one concern, that we want to live peacefully. I want to live in a Kashmir where mother do not say, beta, did you eat? But instead, she is saying, beta, did you take the ID card? That's a fact in Kashmir. Mother do not say. And I don't want to live in a system where you are not supposed to come after 8, where you are not supposed to travel in night. I don't want to live in a system where Pulwama terror attacks happened, and where after Pulwama attack, people, innocent people are being harassed outside the states. I don't want to live in a system where the government people support the rapists of 8-year-old girl. We don't need your roti, kapda and makan. I think that is the God who will give the roti. I believe in that thing. That's the God who give you roti, kapda and makan. Narendra Modi, Rahul Gandhi cannot give me that. But there is only one thing in Narendra Modi and Rahul Gandhi. Then they can give me relief from the sufferings. I don't need to go outside my state for 1 year. And I have to see my home after 1 year. I have to see my mother after 1 year just because of the system. Because my Kashmir, it's not a poor state. It has every kind of resources. It has hydropower projects. It has agriculture. It has apple industry. It has dry food industry. Tourism. Everything. It has tourism. It is not at all poor state. It is far, 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 far. It can be developed if the system comes, really, really desirable system comes there. So my concern is only that we want a change. We want a change in our livings. And we want to change. Somebody said that Ishq ne mujhe meer taki meer bana rakha hai, dard ne mujhe Kashmir bana rakha hai. Thank you.
Appreciate Adul to join this debate. And I just want to ask something about, like, what you have said. Like, not only you, most of them. Like, somebody supported Congress and you supported BJP, Narendra Modi, Rahul Gandhi. So many things I said. But actually, like, for the past 5 years, can you list out 5 things Narendra Modi has done to this country, other than he strike back to Pakistan, done surgical strikes, demonetization, something relevant that he has done to the country, as not your, like, your bias to BJP or someone, as a citizen of India, what you have got? The 5 things can you list out? And from that 5 things, we can move this debate further.
Giving good food as compared to previous one.
Let him say.
Cleanliness of platforms. This is 1 point.
Cleanliness of trains.
Trains. Complete trains. Swachh Bharat. Okay. First point is that. Second point, beti bachao, beti padhao wala.
thing.
Third point.
Hey,
wait.
Give him time. He'll say.
The railways which were developing around 26 kilometers per day, they were roads which were developing, that has been increased. That has been increased. And now they are developing around 120 kilometers per day. Now, there were many projects like Shakti Mission, which was recently happened. Shakti, we became fourth country in the world anti-missile to launch anti-missile system. Fourth, and the fifth one we can say that we become fifth most economically strong country in the entire world. Beating Germany, France. Wait.
So he completed five.
Wait. So this was the 5 points.
What about this wall? Mexican. Okay.
So, one second. Actually, we want to hear a different voice. So, what is this?
Ladies have to talk about this issue.
Actually, this discussion was more about like whether Modi or Rahul, and there are people who are indifferent to politics, political parties, and I think both these parties are like more like corporates, and there are people who wish for a miraculous third party which will come this election. Maybe it's fictitious, but there are people like that.
Tell about your political view of the Lok Sabha election 2019.
Not like that. I agree with her statement, whatever she's saying. It's not like UPA or NDA, the first thing. And the second one is why I'm not against Narendra Modi and so-called NDA. Just tell me the reason why I'm not opposing Narendra Modi or BJP. Just tell me one thing. These are the mother branches of so-called RSS. They have the mentality of RSS mentality. And you can understand what is RSS. They completely, they are goons. And they just want to implement in our society. There is nothing in progress in between 5 years. And again, they are saying that we should once more, Namo Modi. Just come Modi. Modi is nothing. And I don't know who are influenced by Narendra Modi. There is a third party. We will support the third one. That Mahagathbandhan or any, please don't neglect that one. Regional parties, definitely they will play an important role. So please be careful about this one. Thank you.
Let me tell you one thing. I remember studying in my 8th standard history textbook, there was a question, what was the main reason for world wars? And the answer for that was ultra-nationalism or extreme nationalism. And let me remind you, that same thing is happening in India present now. Don't think it's a positive, it's the biggest negative, I'll tell you. I'll share my personal experience, this truth, my personal experience. I studied in Mangalore, business management, and while I was in third year, I just shared a post of Raghuram Rajan criticizing Modi's demonetization. And immediately what message I received in my group, which had 70 students, and most of them were supporting that viewpoint, that is that you should go to Pakistan. That was the view what I got from my, campus group, where I studied for 3 years. Imagine. This is India. Not what 120 km per speed train or 120 km per speed your road. This is India. What are you doing with the society? What are you doing? And what are you doing with India's history? You are starting to teach that every medieval history. I guess even you'll be having that same mindset. Every medieval historians are looters. They came with that religion, they destroyed these temples, and you only that sort of things. And whatever name they have attached to any building, any monument, any roads, everything should be renamed. Aditya Nath government is on the process of this, and he's himself thrown out Taj Mahal also from the UP government's tourism list. This is what message are you going to show to the minority of this country? You're telling that you people came from outside to destroy this temple and you should go to Pakistan. This message is given by your government to the minority of this country. And being a minority person, I feel ashamed that I'm staying here right now. I feel ashamed. It's not that whom I should shoot or loot. It's like I can't read our daily newspaper. Do you know that thing? Just more. If I read the newspaper, what news I'm hearing, whatever it be mob lynchings or some person is named. My name is Abdul Basit, okay? I don't know whether I can speak like this after 5 years. This is the situation what you people have created. And the same thing. And you might be telling that we attacked that country, we destroyed that country. You're not knowing what you're doing within the country. You are attacking within your own people. You are destroying our own country. You have a Pakistan. Are you showing a government by showing that you have an enemy? So you need to choose this government. You have a Hindus are in terror. So you need to choose that. This is the motto of BJP. If BJP doesn't come, Pakistan will win. Pakistan will survive. What help Pakistan here? What help Pakistan? Now you are having to show enemy. That's why you are using it. Is that so? And if you tell that Pakistan is afraid terrorism, If you are showing that Pakistan is afraid terrorism is, they are attacking India because India has got a strong government. Let me remind, I don't want a government whom our enemies also hate. I want a government whom not only our people but even our enemies respect. That should be the government of India. Okay.
So, thanks for gathering over here. Actually, we didn't expect such a huge crowd. In the beginning, there were only 5 to 6 people, but everyone gathered, and thanks for making this first event a huge success. Hopefully, we will conduct a second session for the same because nobody is actually satisfied with the time. So, hopefully, we will conduct a second session. Thanks, everyone. Thanks a lot.